Sponges are a phylum of primarily filter feeders that live their adult lives attached to a substrate. They are simple invertebrates and are the most primitive of the multicellular animals. Sponges have no internal organs or tissues. There are over 8,000 known living sponge species. They live on hard surfaces or soft sediments. Most species are found in the ocean, but some can be found in fresh water. Depending on the species, sponges can be many different shapes, sizes, and colors. Some are tubular, while others are encrusting, branching, or boring. The structure of many species, which consists of a network of canals and chambers with flowing water, allows for the creation of microhabitats, hosting a variety of flora and fauna, such as shrimp or hydrozoans. A sponge's body is made up of groupings of cells that work together to meet the sponge's needs. Cells called pinacocytes form a skin-like layer on the sponge's outer surface. These cells protect the sponge. Sponge bodies are covered in tiny pores. The pores are actually porocytes. These are elongated cells that connect the outside of the sponge to their inside cavity. These pores are also called ostia. The pores provide an opening for water that carries food and oxygen to enter the sponge's body. An opening called an osculum allows water to leave the sponge. The inner surface of the sponge is lined with cells called collar cells, or choanocytes. The collar cells have fine tubes with tiny hair-like structures called flagella that move back and forth, creating a current. This allows water to move into the ostia and out the osculum. The water brings in tiny food particles like bacteria, plankton, and detritus. The fine tubes of the collar cells filter out the food particles and take them into the cells for digestion. Between the outer and inner surface of a sponge is a jelly-like material. An exception to the normal sponge body structure and feeding process is deep-sea carnivorous sponges. These sponges may use barbed hooks or sticky threads to capture small prey items. Some sponges, like those used for natural bath sponges, are made of a soft fiber called spongin. Other sponges have a stiff skeleton made of hard spicules. Some are made of both. Spicules may be made of calcium carbonate or silica. Each cell of a sponge individually exchanges oxygen and carbon dioxide and discharges waste products into the seawater. Because of this, sponges have no respiratory, circulatory, or excretory system. Depending on the species, sponges can reproduce using many different methods of both asexual and sexual reproduction. Some can reproduce asexually by budding. Some reproduce sexually through synchronous spawning, where they eject sperm into the water that fertilizes the eggs. The resulting larvae drift with the current before settling on a suitable substrate. Most sponge larvae have limited swimming capabilities, causing many sponge species to be endemic to a specific region. Sponges can produce chemical compounds with useful pharmaceutical properties, such as anti-tumor, anti-infective, and anti-inflammatory properties. Many sponges produce toxins to deter other organisms from growing near them. Natural sponges are still harvested for personal, industrial, and artistic use. For more marine facts, click the subscribe button